What's going on, everyone? Welcome, Rabid here, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how to mine Xelis in Windows on your GPU. So in order to do so, you're going to need WSL2 installed. This is a Linux subsystem that allows you to run Linux programs, miners, and so on in Linux on Windows. Crazy stuff. But if you don't have WSL2 installed yet, be sure to check that video down in the description. It will get you set up, and then continue on with this guide to get rolling. Alright, so once you're inside of your WSL here, we're going to go in and find our actual miner. So here we can see I'm going to be using the Allfather's GPU miner. We're going to scroll down and I want to right click right here. This is the miner we need, and I'm going to copy the link address and then close out this window. So bring back up our PowerShell that is in WSL, and I'm going to go mkdir. This is going to make a directory. You don't have to do this, but it's going to make it easier, especially if you start using different coins, to name them all in their own directories with their own miners. So I'm going to go make directory, Xelis here. There we can see. Now if I go ls, this will bring up the directory. I might have a whole bunch in here. I might not have nothing. Yeah, I have too many. So anyway, we made that directory. So I'm going to go cd space Xelis. That way I know where it is. And now you can see it's kind of hard to see with the blue on blue, but I am in Xelis at this point. So the folder we just created with that mkdir space, whatever folder you want to call it. At this point, we need to download that miner. So I'm just going to type in wget here, and then we're going to right click, which is the paste command here. And there you can see the miner from the GitHub link we copied. I'm simply going to hit enter and it's going to download it. There we go. It is all done. If I do an ls again, you can see inside of the Xelis folder we created, we can now see the miner is downloaded. So in order to run this, all we got to do is pretty much set up a bat file, copy and paste it in, and our miner will begin running. All right, so I shouldn't have shut down the GitHub yet, because we do need to know what we got to put in our bat file. And to make a bat file, all you got to do is open up a new notepad. I already got mine set up, but this is all you got to do is copy this right here into a notepad worker here, which I have right here, paste it in, and change all the parameters so it matches your hardware. Don't copy mine, use yours. So host, this is my node's IP because I am mining to my own node here. We can see the ./Xelis tax miner here, and then we got our host command, which is right here, IP port. This is my IP and port for my node on my local IP. If you use this, it won't work for you unless you get lucky and you have the exact same router as me, then it might work, but you know, it's not going to work for you. You won't be able to connect to your host here. Here we have --/ wallet, just like it says here. This will be your Xelis wallet right here. Add the --/ boost command. That will give you a boost. It is not guaranteed to work on all GPUs. Give it a shot. If it works, it works. If it doesn't, it doesn't. You know, go on from there. I'm not sure which GPUs it all works on. And then for your worker name, it's --/ worker, and I'm going to name this 3060 Ti. So all we got to do at this point is copy this command. Once you get it in your bat file, right click, copy. I actually saved this with my other miner. So if I come into here, this is my Luna miner folder for my CPU. I just made that bat file there, and then I can just open it up each time I need it. If I got to run WS for my GPU, copy this, and we're going to jump into my WSL here and kind of show you how this works. So before I actually do that, I want to set some overclocking as well. And I do recommend LOL Miner GUI for this. So all you got to really do is download any of the latest versions of LOL Miner. I'm going to right click the LOL Miner GUI. You're going to want to run this as an administrator. Hit yes right there. Close out this background. So I'm going to click on clock. I'm going to click on core offset and click on locking my memory. So I'm going to go 5001 for my memory. Oh, wrong keyboard here. I'm using two keyboards, so I'm messing myself up. So 5001 on the memory here because I am capture carded in. We're going to go 300 offset, and then I'm going to use a core clock of 1400. I haven't fully tweaked for this yet, so obviously you can tweak around, change your core clock, put it up, put it down, but that's why I also like to have MSI afterburner here. I can kind of keep an idea on the power. Now this is software power. You're going to be using more at the wall, but it's a good indicator of exactly whereabouts you are. So I'm going to apply those OCs, and as we can see right here, when I minimize this, everything changed. Here's our 5000 memory lock. We're at 1410, so a little bit more, but I wanted 1400 here, and then the offsets in here as well. So at this point, our GPU is all set up. I am going to bring up the PowerShell here as we're still navigated to where we are with our where we downloaded Xelis tax miner, and I'm just going to bring this up again. It should still be copied, but I'm just going to make sure it's still copied. minimize this, and I'm simply going to paste in this command. That's telling the program to run with all of these commands here. I'm just going to hit enter, and we should connect to our node, set it up, and begin mining. So we can't connect to the node, and I'm glad this is happening. So it's going to be a very simple fix here. I find when I have to bring new rigs onto my node, I'm going to have to reset my node. I don't know why, but sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. But in this case, I'm going to bring up my node right here, and we can see everything here. I only have 4 rigs connected. I should be at 5 now. So I'm going to stop my node. I got to stop my ETCMC node also. So we're going to stop this because I don't want it to glitch out on me. And I'm simply going to reset my node PC. So I'm going to stop, restart, and I'm going to wait for this to play out. All right, so my remote access to my node came back online. So I'm simply going to come into here. And I just want to bring up the rig. You can see it's still trying to connect to the node. There's no connection then. So coming back in, boom. And now I want to go into my documents. I'm going to go into my Xelis here. This one, and now I'm going to do my node start. It's going to start firing up my node again. Things should start connecting. So bam, stop. And now we should start to see some connections happen through. So I'm just going to bring that up again while we wait. And here we can see right away it connected to the node. So this is an issue I find. Sometimes you can connect right away, but other times if I add a new rig or a new GPU or anything, it won't connect. And I do have to restart the complete PC that my node is on. But now we can see we are all connected here. If we go back into it, we should now have 5. Well, it looks like now another rig is not running. So I just want to see list miners, what's not connecting for me right now. I got the 4090s connected, the Octominer 1. It looks like the Octominer 2 is not connecting right now. So we're troubleshooting as we do this as well. So now I got to jump into my Hive OS and see what the heck is going on here. Or maybe my Octominer crashed on me. So we'll just see. Go to Octominer 2. Doesn't seem to be working. So I'm just going to web shell. I'm going to go into user 1. Bam, and we see 0 hash rate. Okay, that's okay. I'm just going to let it wait for a bit. Oh, it can't connect to the node. So I might have to do another. Okay, I just have to wait longer, and it connected. So I'm glad these things are popping up. Obviously, I could just edit out and make everything look perfect, but you do run into these hiccups. So it's nice to see. Just give it a few minutes here. It did connect. I'm coming back to the node. We now have 5 workers connected here. I'm coming into here. We're finding hashes. We can see we're only using 72.2 watts, so I can do a lot more tweaking, maybe add some more core, get some more hash rate, but that's it. We're up and mining in Windows on our GPUs to our own node in Xelis. So hopefully this video did help you guys out. Thank you for watching. And one thing I want to point out, I can't remember if I said it earlier or not, but drivers for your NVIDIA GPU. This is definitely another thing I should point out as well, is that to update your drivers, you don't have to do anything in Linux. All you got to do is simply come in to your actual rig like you normally would in Windows and go to your NVIDIA control panel, update your drivers there, and that's how you would update your drivers for both WSL as well as Windows. You don't have to do anything fancy in WSL itself other than what I just told you. When it comes to the drivers and stuff, do everything like you normally would in Windows. So again, thank you for checking this out, guys. I will see you on the next one. Rabid out.